If you've ever felt unsure about what colour to choose for your products on Redbubble or other print-on-demand platforms, then this video will be helpful for you. I'll show you how to choose the best colours that result in t-shirt sales, as well as sales of other products. The sales will increase by choosing appropriate colours because they make your design stand out more to customers in the search results. More attractive products results in a better click-through rate, and the more people that view your item, the more sales you're gonna get. I'll show you how to quickly and easily test colour choices in real time so you can choose something suitable, both based on your own perception and on computer-generated complementary colours. This is what I use in Photoshop. It's just a mock-up template and it helps me determine what colour I'll use for print on demand. If you want to use the same one, I'll include the PSD file in the description and you can download it for free. The first thing that you'll need to do is put your transparent design onto the shirt. You can literally just drag the PNG file into Photoshop on top of the template and then position it if you want to check something as quick as possible. But if you want to actually use this as a mock-up for marketing purposes, then you can double click this section down at the bottom, which will open a new tab with an empty canvas. All you need to do is drag the design in, position it and save. The t-shirt mockup will automatically update when you press save, and if it doesn't look right, just go back and move the design around until it does. The t-shirt colour for this mockup is black by default, and that's a fine choice for most designs. Customers love black and dark shirts, and when it comes to Redbubble, they'll have the option of buying black on the standard shirt because you can't customise the default colour palette anyway. But if you want to make your design stand out in the search results and you aren't sure what colour to use, this is how we're going to determine it. Firstly, double click the colour here in Photoshop and it will open up the colour picker. You can manually move this selection around by clicking to see what looks good. Just click around on different colours and hopefully if you've got an eye for it, you'll see something that looks really good. But if you don't, like me, you can just use the eyedropper tool, which is selected by default when you open this window. Use the eyedropper to select parts of your design so the colour of the shirt matches different aspects of your artwork. So here we've got the green from the horse, and you can see how the shirt was updated in line with the design when I clicked it. Or you can do the brown from the horse's hooves, the orange from the spooky pumpkin head, or the yellow from the eyes. Usually, when you select colours from your artwork like this, it makes a suitable and attractive colour choice for the t-shirt because it all looks uniform, as if the colour choice is an extension of the design, rather than a last minute thought when it comes to uploading. What you can also do is use a free website called Paletton, which I'll put a link for in the description as well. You can use the site to find a complementary colour. First, select the aspect of the design that you want to find a complementary colour for, so we'll go with the spooky pumpkin, nice orange colour. Once you've clicked it, you'll be presented with the hex code in the box on Photoshop, which you can then copy from here. We're going to then paste that code into Paletton in this box down at the bottom. Just click it and paste. By default, Paletton is set to monochromatic, meaning one colour. So we'll click this text underneath here which says add complementary, and this shows you what colour complements it as well as giving you various shade options to choose from too. All you need to do is hover over the colour that you like the look of and you'll be presented with the hex code that you can use in Photoshop or even just copy directly to print on demand sites. So for example, we've got 1A728F. So I'm just going to copy that and put it in Photoshop so you can see how the design stands out against the complementary colour. That's what it looks like. You can type the different codes in and experiment with lighter and darker shades of the same colour until you find one that you love. So we'll try 579AB1. 579, that actually looks quite good already. AB1. Actually, 579AB looks best in my opinion. At the point when you're happy with the colour choice that you've got, you just need to take the same hex code from Photoshop and copy it into Redbubble or your favourite print-on-demand site. On Redbubble, you select the product that you want to change and apply the code using the box at the side like this. If the box shows up red like it is doing now, it's because it isn't a complete hex code. So the code was 579AB1, but I knocked the 1 off the end because it looked better. This auto-corrected in Photoshop, but on Redbubble, they need the full code. You can fix that by just putting a 0 at the start of the code. Alternatively, if you do copy the complete hex code, it'll work just fine and you won't get a red box. You can apply the code to individual products, so as you go down, you can have different colours for different items if you want, or if you want to apply one colour to all your products, just scroll up to the top of the page and input the hex code. You'll notice that standard and large print clothing haven't been affected. That's because we aren't allowed to set our own custom colours for these, but the rest of the products will get updated, so just scroll down and you'll see. When you've finished, you can change the background colour in Photoshop to whatever you want by double-clicking down here on the bottom layer. Once you've found a colour that you're happy with, you can save the entire design to use as a mock-up for promotional purposes if you're doing your own advertising. You don't have to do that if you want to be successful because Redbubble does advertise your products for you, but if you've decided that you want to promote your own work to get some more sales, then at least you've got a colour-coordinated mock-up that's already been made for you. I didn't make this mock-up template myself, I just edited it so it was easier to use. It was originally from freedesignresources.net and it has a 100% free license so you can use it for whatever you like. I'll also put a link to the original mock-up if you want to look at that. Hopefully you found that helpful. If you did, please like, subscribe and check out my other videos.